I don't know if we showed the pre-market trade, but it's up quite a bit. Analysts didn't really have a very good feel for what the company, I don't know why, but can you explain how you can miss that? Stock's up 10% this morning.
Yeah, it's a great question. And usually with such a great growth of B2C, and good morning, Joe, such a great growth of residential and B2C volumes, you'd have such a negative impact on margin because it is more expensive to go to the home because you have much lower density. So given that, and given the supersized growth that we saw in the quarter, we were all expecting to see greater pressure on margins. They did a phenomenal job of increasing density and being able to counter the negative impacts of increasing B2C deliveries, and really surprised on the margin upside because of all, whether it's automation, whether it's increased density, all of the above helped them really outperform on the ground. And that really was the upside surprise.
They've had to watch expenses and capacity and everything else, Ken, and haven't built out as much this time. Are they leveraged to return to old highs in the stock? What happened? Do you attribute it to Amazon or competition?
Well, you got to remember there were a couple things that have happened over the last couple of years, whether it was their acquisition of TNT, which you remember they bought for just over $4.5 billion, and they've already had over $1.5 billion of integration expenses. So things went awry on the TNT acquisition. You've lost all of their Amazon business, which was almost $900 million of revenues that they lost mostly to UPS. They've rolled out Saturday and Sunday delivery, so adding two more days, you can imagine their increased expenses and you lose the density there. So a lot of things have worked against FedEx over the last period of time, call it year, 2 years. And now you're starting to see that past the bottom, and that's why you're seeing such a positive reaction to the stock today. When you finally have a lot of the negatives out of the way and you've lowered numbers quarter after quarter, we upgraded back a couple months ago, and this is the after effect of seeing kind of that past that bottom and seeing the upside swing now.
The transportation average hasn't fared quite as badly. Does FedEx still represent everything that we should consider goes into what moves that average, or do we need to think of it differently now because of digital and new age? Just the realities of 2020.
It's a really interesting question, just because when you think about the rails, trucks, and air freight, right, the trucks are certainly a leading indicator by about, call it 6 months, and then the rails a couple of months, given the raw material moves, the trucks move the last mile. And the air freight were always concurrent, but the air freight guys really did take it, UPS, FedEx, really took it a little bit deeper into economic downturns because they still run a fixed network. They still have to run that network and promise you delivery. So when those volumes disappear, you lose that operating leverage. So when that starts to come back, you certainly see that leverage. So yeah, they're still a bellwether when you think about seeing the economy. But the thing that switched is that last point you made, which is the switch to more e-commerce or B2C, which is now changing the dynamics, since 75% of what FedEx moves is still business B2B type of goods. And so as you make that change, you've got to solve for that lack of density issue. And it's taken these companies a while, and UPS just started seeing it a couple quarters ago, and hopefully we're starting to see that reaction with FedEx in this quarter's results.